Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to have an introduction to alkynes. So I'm going to draw the simplest alkyne here. An alkyne is a molecule that has a triple bond between carbons. So that triple bond is going to consist of one sigma bond plus two pi bonds. And those pi bonds being more available because they're either above and below or in front and in back of the plane of the molecule are going to be sort of the reactive part of the alkyne. So if we think about just bonding, I'm going to draw my sigma bond just as a line. So this would be sigma, sigma, and sigma. And then there's a pi bond for the alkyne, one above and below the plane of the molecule. And then another one is going to be in front and in back of the molecule because they can't fit above and below. That space is already occupied. So there's one that is in front and in back of the molecule. So it's sort of this cylinder completely full of electron density, really overlapping on top and on the bottom, in the front and in the back, and then directly between the two nuclei with the sigma bond. And pi bonding in organic chemistry is between unhybridized p orbitals. So you have a set of p orbitals on the carbons that are vertical, and then another set that would be perpendicular, the green ones that are sticking out in front and in back of the molecule. So the alkyne has an sp hybridization, and so it has two hybrid sp orbitals and then two unhybridized p orbitals where the pi bonds are, like we drew on the previous page. The bond angle here is 180 degrees. So the farthest apart I can get two things is exactly opposite, 180. So the shape of this molecule is linear. With respect to hybridization, sp is the most electronegative carbon. So an sp hybridized carbon, like that in an alkyne, is going to be more electronegative than an sp2 hybridized carbon, like what you would see in an alkene, and even more electronegative than an alkane, where you just have all carbons and hydrogens, no pi bonds in there. And this electronegativity is going to manifest in that it is easier to pull a proton off of an alkyne than it is an alkene or an alkane. So it's still going to be a weak acid. It's not very easy to pull a proton off, but you can deprotonate it if you use a strong base. So say I have some strong base and it is going to deprotonate this alkyne. So the strong base is going to pluck off that terminal H and those electrons are going to go onto that carbon right there. If I use a strong base, I can get an appreciable amount of the alkyne that is deprotonated. So there's a lone pair on there. And then I would have the conjugate acid of my strong base over there. But the reason for this increased acidity really has to do with the stability of the product that you're making relative to if it had been an alkene or an alkane. So the electrons here are gonna be in an sp hybridized orbital. And that sp hybridized orbital has half s character. An s character is going to give it more of a spherical shape. So those electrons are going to be held closer to the nucleus of the carbon atom and therefore more stabilized. Okay, so I'm going to say electrons are stabilized by that increased s character because they are closer to the positively charged nucleus. And so it's still not going to be a strong acid, but you are able to deprotonate it. And that is going to give way to reactivity for alkynes that we don't typically see for alkenes and alkanes. And you'll watch that in another video about the alkylation of alkynes. So this has been a look at an introduction to alkynes. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.